Welcome back, everyone. Supporters of Arizona's Get Tough policy say they're already working by chasing illegal immigrants back across the border, but not to Mexico. Many of them are heading to New Mexico. CNN's Gary Tuchman has the story.
Hector is new here in Santa Fe, New Mexico. He's 34, looking for work. And like many other illegal immigrants, you could say he's here because he felt he had to get out of Arizona.
How long have you lived in New Mexico?
New Mexico, 2 weeks.
2 weeks. And you lived in Arizona before that?
Yeah, for 12 years.
12 years.
In Arizona, Hector had a full-time job as a car mechanic. But with the state's new immigration law, he realized something. He did not want to be arrested.
You were afraid?
Yeah.
This man is also an illegal immigrant, Pedro, also just arriving here in New Mexico from Arizona. So now he too is looking for steady work like he used to have. In fact, by comparison to Arizona, New Mexico is welcoming to illegal immigrants. We met Pedro at a free lunch supplied by a church in Santa Fe.
Were you scared to stay in Arizona?
Oh, yes. I really scared.
And how do you feel now in New Mexico?
Oh, very comfortable.
It's easy to see why New Mexico could be a more comfortable atmosphere for an illegal immigrant. Here, illegal immigrants can get driver's licenses. In Arizona, they can't. They can also get in-state tuition at colleges. In Arizona, they can't. But here's something else they're also finding out. There are far fewer jobs than in Arizona.
Advocates who help immigrants in New Mexico say that while they're welcomed here, they also warn them there's not a lot of work for them.
We don't have a very large percentage of immigrants, in part because we're a very poor state.
We don't know how many illegal immigrants from Arizona are now heading to New Mexico. But Paul Morrison, chairman of the Santa Fe County Republican Committee, says the state needs to draw a line.
Do you feel illegal immigrants who can't get legal status should go back to Mexico?
Probably yes, on balance, although I'd rather they got a legal way in.
But most of them said they can't get it, so what do you advise them to do?
I don't know. I don't have an answer.
We've heard the same story from many illegal immigrants. Becoming legal is not easy. Pedro says he paid an immigration lawyer to help him.
So you gave this lawyer $5,000 to see if he can make you a citizen.
Mm-hmm.
He told you...
No chance.
No chance.
Right.
And what happened to the money you gave him, the $5,000?
He gave me $2,500.
He gave you half of it back?
Yes.
But he kept $2,500?
Yes.
Other illegal immigrants we've talked with who've been here for years say they haven't taken steps to become legal citizens because they don't want to be sent back to Mexico to wait out the process. Often, their entire families are in the U.S.
Meanwhile, Hector left his wife and four children behind in Arizona until he finds steady work. But if he doesn't, he's come to a conclusion he never imagined.
Maybe I'm waiting for a couple more weeks and no work. Maybe I'm going to Mexico.
To Mexico?
Mexico.
Back home.
My state.
Su país, su country.
For people like Hector, fleeing Arizona may ultimately lead to a return to Mexico, which is precisely what many want from the new immigration law. Gary Tuchman, CNN, Santa Fe, New Mexico.
And the immigration debate has gotten so hot, it has at least three U.S. senators suggesting a change to the U.S. Constitution. The 14th Amendment, to be specific. This is the amendment that says all persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States and of the state wherein they preside. Or reside. This basically guarantees if immigrants have children in the U.S., the kids automatically are citizens. Well, Senator John Kyle wants to hold hearings and maybe alter the amendment. He and others think the 14th Amendment was never meant to apply to illegal immigrants, that it was intended to guarantee citizenship for African Americans after the Civil War. Well, some scholars say that isn't exactly true, that the 14th Amendment was also designed to create a national standard of citizenship for everybody, like the children of Irish and Chinese immigrants. Here's some of the debate from AC 360. First, with an Arizona state senator who co-wrote the state's tough new immigration law, then with a history professor.
The 14th Amendment was written in 1866, ratified in 1868, belonged to one group of people only, African Americans, to give them their rightful place at the table that they were being denied after that war. Had nothing to do with foreigners at all, legal or illegal.
Well, actually,
there was no illegal.
I just got to jump in because that's not true. We've been doing some research.
What is not true?
Well, the congressional
Let me finish.
Okay. Well, in 2005, the Congressional Research Service did a report, and they point out that the original debate over the 14th Amendment, while overwhelmingly about African Americans, it was also among both proponents and opponents about Chinese immigrants here and whether the children of foreign workers, of Chinese workers, should actually get citizenship.
That's okay. Let's go back to the case. That's not true. First of all, it was clear. And on the debate of the floor, Jacob Howards and Senator Cohen, both those senators made it clear it did not apply to aliens or foreigners in any manner. That was the debate on the floor.
The 14th Amendment was debated for months, and the wording was very, very carefully worked out. If they had meant to exclude any kind of people, aliens, children of aliens, they would have done so.
It wasn't just about African Americans, though. That was the main.
Primarily to establish the unquestionable citizenship of African Americans, which before the Civil War, the Dred Scott decision had said no black person could be a citizen. But it was also to create a national standard of citizenship for everybody, not just black people, children of immigrants, Irish immigrants, anybody.
Senators Lindsey Graham and Mitch McConnell also support taking another look at the 14th Amendment. Why don't we get a